Hey guys, Phil Wickham here to tell the story behind the song For God So Loved. Man, I love singing this song. It's almost word for word taken out of John 3:16, which I love just using the scripture as lyrics for songs. I think it's pretty powerful to do that, you know, but sometimes it's hard and doesn't feel right. But I was in Nashville. I'm from San Diego, but I'd taken a trip to Nashville to write with some friends, and I was in a co-write with a guy named Jason Ingram and some other guys. Jason has written so many amazing songs over the years. And at the end, you know, I had this for probably a year. I had in my writing notebook just said, write a song called For God So Loved, because I didn't know of a song yet called that. That's a worship song. And I just thought, man, that feels like an amazing springboard just to kind of to go wherever you want, but using John 3:16 as like the chorus and the main anchor for the song. And so I told him, I was like, man, I've wanted to write a song for like a year called For God So Loved. I don't know what it's supposed to sound like or what else it's supposed to say. As we were kind of going to our cars at the end of the day, we were going to write again tomorrow, the next day. And I remember when I told it to him, I saw in his eyes that just, you know, when you see in a writer's eyes, like, okay, yeah, that's, like, I know, I felt like a light bulb turned on in his mind, like, okay, that there is something there, yeah, we're going to write it. And then when I met with him the next morning, he's like, well, it's like, I couldn't go to sleep last night after you told me that, so I wrote this chorus, and he showed it to me. It's, for God so loved the world. The whole chorus, you know. He gave his one and only son. And then he's like, I just need a second half. And I was like, my debt is paid, oh praise. And I started singing it, and it was like, okay, that chorus was written in 5 minutes. That was easy. And then like, well, what about verses? And then we started playing these chords, and he started singing a melody, and I started singing lyrics over it. I mean, it never happens. Like, I usually spend so much time working on songs and rewriting, but this song literally was probably done in about 13 minutes. And I remember just, both, like, he was playing piano, I was like walking around the writing room like, yes! Just singing as loud as I could, the song. And so I remember that moment really fondly, because I felt like God was really moving in that room. And so I felt like it was such a strong, just kind of last sentiment to say on this. My new record's called Living Hope. And so For God So Loved is like the last final thing. For God so loved the world, he gave his one and only son. Amazing grace, my debt is paid. Oh praise the risen one, for God so loved. And man, I love ending all, this whole record's about hope and wanting more of God in our life and asking God for more of his presence and to be more aware of him and the cross and redemption. And it kind of goes all these places. And I just felt like to put a period at the end of this whole kind of worship record, just to kind of end with this truth about like, all of this is possible because of what Jesus has done on the cross. And John 3:16 obviously says, for whosoever believes in him will not die but have everlasting life. And so we're like, man, we need that belief response. Like, so I'm gonna believe it. I'm gonna believe you died, I believe you rose, and I believe you're coming again. Sometimes I find, even when I'm doubting something, or I'm going through times like, do I believe this? Or why don't I feel like I did a week ago? Or, you know, just our humanity kind of is up and down, and emotions can be up and down, and relationships are up and down, and it can happen the same thing with our relationship with Jesus, you know? But I find sometimes just speaking words out of my mind and my mouth, it preaches to my own spirit and my own soul, my own heart. And so to say, I believe you died, I believe you rose, I believe you're coming again, sometimes I need to say that 8 times. Sometimes I need to say it 80 times to remind my heart to believe it and to walk through life with that belief that like there's purpose and reason and goals for my life beyond what I see, and to make me live accordingly, you know. So I hope that this song would make faith arise in people as they sing it, and so thankful for it. For God so loved.